Hello and welcome. My name is Marianne, I'm the Rentals Operations Manager here at Harcourts Pinnacle. Today I wanted to have a quick chat with you about the movement that we're seeing in investment properties here on the north side of Brisbane. We're finding that a lot of people are buying new investment properties on the north side, as well as quite a few investors that are selling them off as well. There just seems to be quite a bit of backwards and forwards right now. So with that in mind, I wanted to have a quick chat with you about whether you can sell with a tenant in place. This is a question that we get quite commonly in the rentals department here at Harcourts Pinnacle. And the answer is yes, you absolutely can. However, there's quite a few factors that you want to consider before making that decision. The first thing that I would do as an investor is to check out the most recent routine reports that is coming through. So have a chat with your property manager. Have a look at how the tenant is presenting the property. Is it presentable enough to be appealing to a buyer? Are the tenants the kind of tenants that a buyer would want to inherit? If yes, excellent. Go ahead. Make sure you get an excellent agent on board, and we'll chat about that in a second. If not, you might want to consider waiting until the property is vacant. The reason being is that there is zero obligation for the tenant to keep the property at a sale standard or at a standard that is showroom worthy. They just have to keep it clean, tidy, damage free, but they don't have to keep it at a condition that is presentable for a sales process. Now, the second point is the sales agent. So you do want to, if you do decide to sell with a tenant in place, you want to make sure that you select an agent that is going to get the tenants on side. It is primarily their role as the agent, because they're going to be the people that are going through the property, going to be showing people through the property, going to build that relationship. You want to be quite selective to make sure it's somebody that you would allow through your home. At the end of the day, if a tenant feels like the sales agent is getting them offside, the sales agent is bullying them, any sorts of things like that, then you're going to get them offside. They can hinder your sales process by making inspections difficult, by not presenting the property well, a number of different factors which might prevent you from getting the best price and the best buyer possible. The other thing is that the sales agent needs to make sure they understand the rental legislation quite well. Now, a lot of people think that is a given. However, in a lot of agencies, the rental and sales department are quite separate, and so the sales agent might not be quite up to scratch, and you'd be surprised with the rental legislation. Something that we do here at Harcourts Pinnacle is to make sure that we provide training for our sales agents on a regular basis so they're up to date with the current legislation. Something that you need to be aware of, that I'd like you to be aware of, is that if you do choose to sell with a tenant in place, if you do that within the first 2 months of a tenant having a new lease, the tenant can leave with only 2 weeks' notice, even if you have a fixed term lease in place. By new lease, I mean it's either a brand new tenant that's moved in within less than 2 months, or you've given them a lease renewal within the last 2 months. They're both considered new leases. If it is outside of that first 2 months, if they've been there for longer than that, then you can sell and the fixed term lease is in place. That also means you can't kick them out just because you want to sell. Some tenants will respond to incentives. However, there is absolutely no obligation for them to relinquish their right to live in that property until the end of that lease term. That's all I wanted to share with you. The three points really are: make sure that property is presented, the tenants are presenting it well, you keep the tenants on side, you select your agent very carefully, and you make sure you're aware of any legislation. Make sure you speak to your property manager. They're most of the time more than happy to help you out. Leave me a comment below if there's any other questions that we can answer for you. Other than that, I will see you next time.